Hey guys, welcome to Silicon Valley Girl. Today we're going to talk about creating digital products. And sometimes when you start a business, you think that there are so many steps that you need to take in order to actually get to your first dollars, that you need to come up with a product, you need to make sure you have inventory, you need to create a website, so many steps that you end up starting selling in a year or 2 years. And the worst mistake you can do is wait, because speed is everything these days. Sometimes you think you need to be perfect to start, but in reality, you need to think of something, a small product that you can start with. Because the earlier you start selling, the earlier you would get feedback from your customers, the better your business model would be. So today we're going to talk about the types of digital products that you can create to test out if there is a market for your service. And I know I have a lot of experience with digital products. We started making them 3 years ago, and last year we made a record high amount of revenue from selling digital products. So if you're interested, continue watching this video. Number one digital product is an ebook. And 3 years ago, I had an idea of making my own book, but then I thought, you know, I need to reach out to a publisher. I need to make sure the publisher is a good one, so it's gonna take a while. But then I realized, because I was doing so many one-on-one consultations, I realized I'm saying the same thing over and over again. And instead of just doing those consultations, I could write a book, sell it for a cheaper price, but with a cheaper price, I could reach more customers and just spend that extra time on creating more videos on YouTube. And this is what I did. I analyzed all the consultations that I've had. I wrote my own book without a publisher, because I started talking to friends and they were like, Marina, you can get published through Amazon. And Amazon has this amazing service where you just submit your text. And if somebody buys a book and they want a physical copy, because Kindle is super easy, but if they want a physical copy, Amazon would print on demand. So you wouldn't have to invest a lot of money upfront in order to have your book printed and thousands of copies in order to sell it. You just do it through Amazon and they print on demand. But at that time, I also thought I didn't really need a physical copy, because my clients were all over the world, because the book was about getting admitted to the US, and a lot of them were in countries where Amazon didn't have that service. So I just created my own ebook. Yes, it took several months to create the content. I hired an editor, because when you write a text yourself and you read it 4 or 5 times, you get so tired and you just miss mistakes. Oh, first cover, I did it by myself using Canva, and I think I paid like $5. But then I hired a designer who made the whole thing look a lot better for, I think, like $200. And I started selling this book for around $20 each. And there's also a second package you can do. You can get this book plus personal statements. I think it's around $29. But the most important thing is that last month we did around $600 in sales, and I stopped promoting my book maybe like 2 years ago. So if you're an expert in something and you think you have enough content for an ebook, go ahead, create an ebook, sell it through your own website or sell it through Amazon. The next thing you can put behind the paywall is a video, but just make sure it's a video worth watching. So for example, I create short videos here on YouTube and they're free, but sometimes I do longer form videos dedicated to one particular topic. And the way I would do them, I would go live and I would actually sell access to that live stream. And I would say, if you are attending this live, you're paying $15, but if you're buying the recording, you're gonna pay $20. And this way I'm just creating the momentum for people to attend the live stream. And for example, I made a live stream about how to start on YouTube. That was before my course, and that live stream lasted 1.5 hours, and I sold access for like $15. And later on, we just sold access to that live stream, and that was an access to a 1.5 hour video. Again, perfect revenue stream. Doesn't take a lot of upfront time and costs to create it. You just need to sit down, create your deck, go live on a platform of your choice. You could use Zoom, you could use YouTube, you can make this unlisted video, unlisted live stream and share the link. And then you create a paywall through Teachable, Wix, or whatever platform there is. The next step is to create the online course. This is a little more complicated, because if you go live, then people don't really care about the quality. But if we're making an online course, both at LanguageRip and my own YouTube online courses, I just want to make sure the content is amazing. I want to make sure the quality of recording is amazing. So on average, it takes me around 3 months to create a course, because it takes a while to create the script for the course and then to record it and then to work with an editor. So depending on how much you want to invest in quality, but I would say the minimum cost of the course would be like $1,000, $2,000 to produce it. And then again, you would need to pay the platform to sell it. I use Kajabi and I use Thinkific to sell my courses. But then Courses are one of the biggest revenue streams for us because we invest so much, but we also heavily promote them. I think this is one of the best products to sell online because it is complete, it is a long format of studying, and you can deliver a lot more information than you can put in one video, for example. The next type of product has several names. You can call it a swipe file. I call them workbooks. You can call them handbooks. So whatever it is, it is a manual on one particular topic, so it's not necessarily a book. I would say the most important difference between a swipe file and an ebook is that swipe file is much more practical. So for example, I have my own swipe file, but I call it workbook, for English language students. And you can check it out by going to english.online. It's a very simple website, but the content itself, this workbook, is 180 plus pages, and it has theory, it has a lot of content, like different tables, different images that help you understand English better, and they also have a lot of practical tasks. So for example, we created cards that you can cut out, you can write words that you need to remember, and you can just carry these cards with you and learn words. There are also a lot of practical exercises, so you can print out the workbook itself and write things down. It's an amazing revenue stream. Every month we make tens of thousands of dollars selling that workbook. It took us around 5 or 6 months to create it, and it was me, another influencer, two designers, three copywriters, so it was a lot of work, and it cost us maybe around $3,000 to create the whole thing and a lot of our personal time, but I think it's an amazing product. And again, if you're an expert in something, you can create workbooks like that. One thing I want you to remember is that you need to be an expert in something. I see a lot of influencers creating workbooks in the areas that they don't really understand. Like, there's this lifestyle blogger creating a workbook about what you need to eat in a day, and she's not even a nutritionist. I don't think that's a good practice. But for example, if you're an entrepreneur with good experience, or if you're a salesperson, or if you are a nutritionist, a fitness instructor, and if you have enough experience, you can totally create something like this. You can also sell your digital photographs and videos online, and this is what one of my friends does. So he's a photographer and a videographer, and he loves creating content. You don't have to be in those images. So what he does every weekend, he goes somewhere with his girlfriend, he travels around California, creates amazing footage of places where they went. Then he goes to Shutterstock, uploads everything, puts tags, tries to get featured by Shutterstock, and he's able to make from $2,000 to $3,000 every month just by selling his digital images and videos online. By the way, another platform that you can use for that is called Dreamstime. But again, your content needs to be great. Your content needs to be worth paying for. Another thing that you can sell is an exclusive membership. So for example, if you have a group of students, or if you have a group of followers, and you want to create a weekly meetup, that's a great way to monetize your audience. So for example, if you're a real estate investor, you can do weekly meetups where you revise the market, where you tell what's happening in the market and when is the good time to buy. The same for financial investors, the same for teachers. You can do weekly meetups to teach some particular topic. And my team and I are working on a piece of software to make it easier for you to create those weekly meetups and make them recurring, and create the subscription model, because I love subscription, because you only need to onboard a client once, and they keep paying. If you produce good content, they just stay with you for a long time. But yeah, follow me on Instagram, Lingua Marina, if you want to be one of the first people to try out our new feature. I'm really excited about it, because I really believe in small group meetups behind a paywall, so you can get curated audience, and I really believe in subscription models. The next thing you can create is a plan. So it's very similar to a workbook, but it's shorter. So for example, you are a fitness instructor, and instead of creating an online course, which would take a while for you to record, to create, to edit, you can create different plans. So exercise plan for those who wants to train their legs, or exercise plan for those who want to lose weight. So different plans, and I think the price point here would be $3 to $5 for a workbook. Our workbook, by the way, it costs $7.95. And it's on the cheaper side. I've seen workbooks that sell for like $20. Courses could vary from $50 to, well, $400. The rest, I think, is too much. Over the roof books cost from $10 to $30. But yeah, plans are the cheapest things you can sell, and they are the easiest to prepare. Again, you have to be an expert in whatever you're talking about, but creating a meal plan, creating an exercise plan, creating a nutrition plan is something you can do. It could be like a 10-page plan. I would invest in a designer. I would really invest your time in creating content, and then you can sell it for $2 to $4. And this is a great product to launch as a first digital product to test out your audience, to see what they're looking for, to see the feedback. And because the price point is so low, it would be easier for your audience to buy something like that. The next digital piece that you can sell are audio files and different sounds. So first of all, you can sell an audio file with information like a paid podcast. But what you can also do, you can also sell music or beats or different sound effects that could be reused by other people. So one of my friends, he's a songwriter and he loves to buy beats from other people because he's better at creating lyrics and creating the music itself, but he needs beats from somewhere else, and this is how other people are able to make money. If you're a graphic designer, I would really pay attention to a platform called Dribbble, because Dribbble allows you to sell logos, fonts, textures, like whatever you can create as a graphic designer, you can sell on Dribbble. Some of my graphic designer friends, they just love to create during their free time without any purpose, and they have a lot of different things sitting there in their laptop. And I just tell them, oh my God, this is an asset. You can go ahead and sell it. So go ahead, check out the platform called Dribbble and see if you can sell something that you have in stock as a graphic designer. The next digital product is online paid magazine. If you feel that you can create a magazine that's subscription-based, that's amazing. But if you're just starting out, you can start with a paid channel. Or for example, you create an Instagram account that is closed and you only let people who paid in. Or you create a Discord channel that is closed to general public and you only let your members in. Or a Telegram channel or a WhatsApp group. And then every day, or maybe every 2 days, every 3 days, depending on what your product is, you deliver some news. So for example, there's an entrepreneur that I know and he has several businesses, and his assistants brief him every morning on what's happening on the markets. At some point he realized he can actually create like a paid channel where he would just share what his assistants do for him. And I think he charges like couple dollars a month, but then you get access to the Telegram channel and you just read news that are curated for entrepreneurs. And I think that's a great idea. And the last but not the least, you can sell content scripts. And let me specify. So for example, if you're a salesperson and you know a perfect script for B2B companies, you can create that script, you can create this template and sell it. And here you can really go really high with your prices, because if you're a B2B, if you're selling this to other companies, I know companies that pay like $10,000 per script. I don't necessarily advise to start with that price point, but this is something where you can get. So sales script, email marketing funnel script. So creating those, I don't know if you've seen them, but there are huge funnels when you're doing email marketing. They're event-based. So if a subscriber clicked this email, we send them this. If he didn't, we send them this. Then there is an OTO, there is an offer, there is a lead page, blah, blah, blah. So a lot of things happening in the back end when you're receiving those emails. You can create a script for that and sell it. You can create scripts that would help people apply and interview for a job. You can create scripts that would help people pitch their startup. Like, there are so many scripts that you can create. Again, if you're an expert in something, go ahead and share this knowledge for a small fee and make your revenue. Thank you guys so much for watching this video up to the very end. Please comment down below if you've tried any of those things, or maybe you have other ideas of digital products that you can sell. The rule that I try to follow is give a little more than people expect with your product. If you're not yet subscribed to this channel, please hit the red button down below, and I will see you very soon in my next videos. And I'm waiting for your likes and comments. See you soon.